The Northrop YF-23 was developed for the U.S. Air Force's Advanced Tactical Fighter Competition in the 1980s. It was one of the two finalists in the competition, but it ultimately lost to the Lockheed YF-22. The YF-23 was stealthier and faster than the YF-22, but it was less agile. In 1981, the U.S. Air Force requested information from several aerospace companies on an advanced tactical fighter. The Advanced Tactical Fighter, or ATF, was supposed to replace the F-15 Eagle, and air-to-air combat would be its primary role. The ATF was to make use of new technologies, such as composite materials, advanced flight control systems, and stealth technology. In 1985, a request for proposal was issued to several manufacturers. At the same time, the U.S. Navy announced that it would consider to use a derivative of the ATF to replace the F-14 Tomcat. In 1986, Lockheed, Boeing, General Dynamics, McDonnell Douglas, Northrop, Grumman and Rockwell submitted proposals. Lockheed, Boeing and General Dynamics formed a team to develop whichever of their proposed designs was selected, if any. Northrop and McDonnell Douglas did the same. In October, Lockheed's and Northrop's proposals were selected as finalists. They were given 50 months to produce and flight test their prototypes. The YF-23 was designed to meet the requirements for survivability, supercruise, stealth and ease of maintenance. Supercruise meant that the YF-23 had to be able to perform prolonged supersonic flight without the use of afterburners. The first YF-23 prototype, nicknamed Black Widow 2, took its maiden flight August 27, 1990, with the second prototype, nicknamed Grey Ghost, following on October 26. The aircraft had diamond-shaped wings and an all-moving V-tail. The cockpit was placed high to provide good visibility for the pilot. A weapons bay was placed on the underside, between the nose and the main landing gear. The first prototype was fitted with Pratt & Whitney YF-119 engines, and the second prototype used General Electric YF-120 engines. The exhaust from the engines flowed through troughs lined with heat ablating tiles to dissipate heat, and shield the engines from infrared homing missile detection from below. The first prototype supercruised at Mach 1.43 on September 18, 1990. And the second reached Mach 1.6 on November 29. The top speed tested was Mach 1.8, with afterburners, and the maximum angle of attack reached was 25 degrees. The actual maximum speed is classified, but is believed to be greater than Mach 2 at altitude. The two YF-23s flew 50 times for a total of 65.2 hours. Evaluation results were submitted in December 1990. In April 1991, the Secretary of the Air Force announced that the YF-22 was the winner. The YF-22 was rated higher on technical aspects, were considered lower risks, and were considered to have more effective program management. The YF-23 prototypes were transferred to NASA, and one of the prototypes was planned to be used for flight testing, but this never took place. The first prototype is now displayed at the Research and Development Hangar of the National Museum of the United States Air Force, near Dayton, Ohio. The second prototype is displayed at the Western Museum of Flight in Torrance, California.